Amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds. The new equipment I ordered for the shop is coming this week.
I gotta get this Black Widow out of here somehow. I could tell there was a new spider in the shop because when I walked in, there was a web over here by this door. Going from, like, the T-Bird to this corner. And then there was a web here. Caught my leg on it. And when I was looking around here, I saw the spider saw me and moved. They're smart. So at nighttime, he's crawling out, spinning webs all over the fucking place. And he's going back into his home, which is the engine bay of the T-Bird. When I went to Home Depot to get paint stripper earlier this week, I also grabbed some remodeling supplies, and I also found a cheap car battery so I could pull the T-Bird out when the dildo machines get here. Don't tell Rafa's mom, it's a surprise.
I'm gonna put on my mechanic's gloves since I'm a mechanic.
This piece of shit won't even idle. I just needed to start up long enough to be able to throw it in reverse and launch it out of the shop. And hopefully I could launch her back in, and then we'll fix it.
The oil's good, still nice and milky.
Last week I talked a little bit about the plasma table, but what I ordered is a 2x2 plasma table with a plasma cutter and a 2x3 CNC router. I have an idea for some products I want to make and be able to sell on my website, but I also want these to be able to build my own car parts with. I just want to be able to make more stuff in a time-efficient manner without having to break my knuckles. I'm over here using a jigsaw for everything. When I first moved into this shop, the first big tool I bought was my table saw. I built a bench around it and I love that thing and I use it all the time. The following year I bought my welder, which is about $1,800, and I love that thing too. I wouldn't trade that for anything. And then my welding table was awesome. All these tools I've accumulated have a lot of value to me, so I just want to keep adding to the collection and adding to the arsenal with bigger and better shit. The stupid-ass battery's already the wrong fucking size, sticking all out. If I shut my hood, it's gonna hit the battery terminals.
I'm going to have to remove the lower plate and cut a new plate with my plasma cutter. Shit's getting all complicated because I bought a cheap battery. I'm really trying to be cheap and save money because I have a car parts budget and I spent over the budget last couple months. I almost have the Amex paid off, but I don't quite want to spend $200+ on a Yellow Top Optima. So then I waste $65 on a piece of shit. At least when I do get my Yellow Top, I can drop this battery off at Rafa's mom's house because I'm sure her dildo battery is running low right now. It's gotta be running low. Last time I dropped off a battery at her house is a month ago.
What you say, B?
This thing won't even stay running. I need to be able to pull it out of the shop and pull it back in. Probably a narrowband O2 sensor that I could use for the mule without having to buy a controller. Sitting in the T-Bird trunk. Last week I asked you guys what you want me to do to the T-Bird. I've been reading through the comments. It looks like the majority of you want to see a wall build and hydraulics, which sounds fun to me. Sounds like a good time. Hop that shit on Rafa's mom. Bam! Watch them titties bounce. I'm gonna try to vacuum up the spider. So what I think we should do is build a wall out of acrylic and make it see-through. We can make acrylic panels cut on the CNC router with a steel frame around it, cut with the plasma cutter. That way you can see through the side windows, through the back window. We're gonna have a transparent double 15 wall build. So we gotta finish the mule. But still, the first pile of car parts we're gonna order is for the mule. We still gotta get the brake pedal assembly, get a throttle cable hooked up to that thing. We need that thing drivable as soon as possible. The head gasket kit for the T-Bird is fairly cheap, and that's gonna take a while. So that's something we could pick away at a little bit on the side while we're getting this fucking mule running. So I'm thinking an acrylic and steel wall build right behind the front seats with two 15s right behind your heads. We could do the amp on the back of the seat where there's no seat anymore because there's a fucking wall there. Not yet, this is all in my head. Then we'll have plenty of room to do a hydraulic setup in the trunk, cut the floor out. We could do a nice boxed in mesh floor so when oil leaks everywhere, it dumps onto the floor. Throw a match out the window. Clean up that mess, and in the meantime, we'll be figuring out the new machines we ordered. Then we'll be making these episodes, an episode a day. We've been trying to make them extra long. We're gonna learn CAD, program some shit, work on some cars, by myself. You look at me like I'm crazy. I have an idea. So
Support Amplified by going to soundmanca.com and picking up an iPad dash kit and Soundman merch. Go to mobilesolutions-usa.com and book your car audio training and check out their tools. And go to ct-sounds.com for some innovative car audio equipment from a company that's giving back to the community. Make sure you guys come back tomorrow for the equipment delivery and every day for a new episode of Amplified. Please leave a comment. You can hit me up on Twitter @DougBernards. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.